ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। नमस्कारम। इट इज शिवरात्रि, वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट ओकेशंस, डायनामिक एंड वाइब्रेंट ओकेशंस दैट एमनेट्स द वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी इन ए साधना। This is the day most of the Shaiva Sadhagas are waiting. And this is called Mahashivaratri. During the Shivaratri, I got an assignment from one of my Shishyas to give a small presentation on Madhaveda Gayatri. Some of you may be wondering why during Shivaratri I am speaking or talking about Gayatri, a feminine goddess. There is a popular stotra ratna, actually I should say, written by Adi Shankaracharya, known as Saundarya Lahari. The first part of the first verse reads like this: Shiva Shakti Ayukto Yadhi Bhavati Shaktah Prabhavitum Nache Devam Devo Nakhalu Kushalas Panditumapi. Without the influence of Bhagavati, Shiva, he cannot even move, not able to move. So it's very relevant for us to meditate upon the importance of Gayatri during Shivaratri. You all will be familiar with the word Veda or the Vedas. There are four Vedas: Rig, Yaju, Sama and Atharvana. Rigveda, Yajurveda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda. And Mother Gayatri is known as Vedamata. So according to the Rishis, all the Vedas are derived from Gayatri only. Hence, Gayatri is known as Mother Veda. It is mentioned in Atharva Veda. In Atharvana Veda, there is a mantra: Stuta Maya Varada Veda Mata Prachodayantam Pavamani Dvijanam Ayu Pranam Prajam Pashum Kirtim Dravinam Brahmavarchasam Mahyam Dattva Vrajada Brahmalokam. This is the mantra. And the Devata voice, this very mantra, is Gayatri. So the Rishi, trying to contemplate actually what is the importance of Gayatri is. And he says, Stuta Maya Varada Vedamata. Maya Stuta Varada Vedamata. She's the goddess. Whatever you pray, she will. Varada, Varadayini, Amba, Varadayini. Jo bhi mango, mil jayenge. Prachodayantam. She is the source of inspiration. Gayatri, Mother Gayatri is the source of inspiration. Pavamani Dvijanam. And she ignite the pavanatva or the purity inside us. And she is the one who clear all the impurities. Pava Mani Dvijanam. द्विजानाम द वन हू टेक्स सेकेंड बर्थ द फर्स्ट बर्थ इज फ्रॉम मदर्स वूम एंड द सेकेंड बर्थ इज फ्रॉम द हर्ट ऑफ योर गुरु दैट्स कॉल्ड द्विजा द्विजा आयुहु एंड शी विल बेस्ट अपॉन यू आयु प्राणम प्राणशक्ति प्रजाम अपत्यम गुड चिल्ड्रन आयु प्राणम प्रजाम पशुम वेल्थ वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ वेल्थ आयु प्राणम प्रजाम पशुम द्रवीणम एंड दिस इज एक्चुअल वेल्थ मनी व्हाट एवर यू कैन से आयु प्राणम प्रजाम पशुम कीर्तिम कीर्ति ब्रह्मवर्चसम वर्च ब्रह्मवर्च हिंदी तो आप हिंदी में तो आप कहते हैं ब्रह्मवर्चस वर्चस्वी होना है मह्यम दत्वा व्रजद ब्रह्मलोकम एंड आफ्टर ऑल दिस काइंड ऑफ वेल्थ एंड शी विल टेक यू टू द डिवाइन अबाउट ब्रह्मलोक ओनली गायत्री टेक्स यू टू द हेवनली अबाउट नॉट द मियर हेवन दैट यू आर रीडिंग लाइक most of the people are very much aware of the term swarga naraka and all so gayatri is not talking about swarga and naraka it is moksha loka mukti loka so she is the one who takes you to the abode of mukti mukti dayini pavamani and bhavatarini sri ramakrishna paramahamsa the great master guru of swami vivekananda keep on telling about the term Bhavatarini. Bhava means the samsara, this world. And the one who takes you to the like other world, that means free from all the bondages. That is Mukti. Mokchat Mohachaya iti Mukti. Free from all bondages. And the Gayatri is the one who takes you to that abode. In Vedic literature, apart from Vedas, we have Vedangas. There are six angas, limbs, to the Veda, Veda Purusha. And it's called Shiksha, Kalpa, Vyakarana, Niruktam, Chanda, and Jyotisha. These are the six limbs of Veda Purusha. Out of these six limbs, Nirukta, Niruktam Shrotram Uchyate. This is a definition given by Sage Panini. Niruktam Shrotram Uchyate. So, the Vedanga of Nirukta helps us to find out the actual definition of each and every words used in mantras. And the word Nirukta means Nishchayena Ukta, arriving into the correct conclusion, definition, defining something, the process of defining something, Nirukta. So, here we are trying to pitch in to find out the actual meaning or definition of the word Gayatri. Here we are looking for our masters like Acharya Shankara and other divine sages like Rishi Bharadwaja. All these rishis try to define the nature of Mother Gayatri. And the definition, first and foremost, or the popular definition of Gayatri is Gayantam Trayate Iti Gayatri. That means Gayatri is the mantra that helps a sadhaga to come out of the all the prarabdha. Dosha prarabdha durita prarabdha karma. Gayantam trayade. Tranan karna, raksha karna. Gaane walon ka raksha karna hi Gayatri ka arth hai. Main Gayatri ka jap karta hu, to Gayatri mata mujhe raksha karti hai. This is the word meaning or the definition of the term Gayatri. Gayantam trayate tasya pranan trayata iti Gayatri. गान करने वालों का जाप करने वालों का प्राणों का रक्षा करने वाला ही गायत्री है This is the definition given by sages, like especially by Rishi Bharadwaj and all. Gayatri is also known as Guru Mantra. Guru means great or the greatest. Greatest of the greatest. That is Guru, Mahat. Like Jupiter is also known as Guru. And Jupiter is the biggest graha in Saurayudha. Guru Mantra. Mantra ma guru hai. Hence, at the time of Upanayana, immediately after Upanayana, there is a sanskara called Vedaramba. And in between, during the thread ceremony, Itnyoma Vidharan karna, Janeyu Dharan karne ka samay. Acharya Shishiko, Upadesh deta hai. Vishmantra, one and only Gayatri. And this is the very first mantra uttered by a guru to his disciple. Hence it's called Guru Mantra. Why? Only with the help of Gayatri, a disciple or a student will be able to master Vedas, Vedic literature and all other branches of knowledge according to ancient Indian system. So, Gayatri Japa is first and foremost duty of any human being who is longing for his studies. Now we can think about other specialities of Gayatri, features of Gayatri. Every mantra, there will be a Rishi and a Chanda and a Devata. Rishi is the one who actually sees the mantra. Mantra drashta, Rishayo mantra drashtaraha. And Rishi Vishwamitra is the Rishi. Vishwamitra Rishi is the sage of Gayatri Mantra. Gadhinaha Vishwamitraha, son of Gadhi. Rishi Vishwamitra is the Rishi of Gayatri Mantra. And the second thing is the Chanda. Yadakshara Parimanam Tachandaha. Akshara, that means alphabets. Number of alphabets arranged in a special manner. It's called Chanda. And the Lakshana of Gayatri Chanda says, each line consists of 8 letters and total 3 padas. Tal, Sa, Vi, Tur, Va, Re, Ni, Yam. 8. Bhar go devasya dhimahi dhiyo yo na prachodayal. 24. So Gayatri mantra is a mantra with 24 letters with 3 padas, and each pada consists of 8 alphabets. It's called Gayatri Chanda. Yadakshara parimanam tachandaha. And the third one, Devata. Devata is the Atma, the heart of the mantra. Mantra Atmano Devata. Devata is the heart of mantra. So here, Savita is the mantra. Savita is the Devata of Gayatri Mantra. Savita. In Laukika Sanskrit or classical Sanskrit, Savita is known as Surya. The sun that is we are depending upon, the all the creatures of the world depending upon the sun. Actually that sun is not the Savita. Even that sun is depending on the Savita. In Upanishad, one of the Upanishad is one of the Upanishads says like this. Natatra suryo bhati nata chandra taragam nema vidido bhati kudo yamagni tameva bhanta manuvadi sarvam tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati natasya suryo bhati. Surya, the sun, never give lights to that. So actually, and last line, Upanishad Rishi says, Tasya Bhasa Sarvam Idam Vibhadi. Actually, that give light to sun and all the celestial world. So we are not merely worshipping the sun. The word meaning of Savita or the Nirukta of Savita is Savita Prasavita. The one who give birth. That is the actual meaning of Savita. the one who gives birth. Savita, Savita, Prasavita. So Gayatri is the mother of the entire universe. Gayatri is the mother of light. Gayatri is the mother of knowledge. Gayatri is the mother of inspiration. Gayatri is the mother of Veda. Gayatri is mother of karma. Gayatri is the mother of moksha. Gayatri eva jagat sarvam. And the power of each and every devadas is Gayatri. Without Gayatri, nothing is there. Gayatri is Mother Veda. So it is for a man or a human being or an Indian to worship Gayatri properly, daily, without any pramada. Do Gayatri Japa 108 times in the morning and in the evening. I started Gayatri Gurukulam only to spread the idea of Gayatri, in order to emanate the knowledge of Vedas, in order to emanate the secrets of Gayatri, impart the secrets of Gayatri. So it's the most powerful mantra that Bharat Rishi had ever invented. Repeat Gayatri. My guru keeps on telling me, repeat Gayatri, repeat Gayatri, repeat Gayatri. And he actually cried, repeat Gayatri, my dear, repeat Gayatri. So how we chant the Gayatri mantra? There are various methods and ways and means to chant the Gayatri mantra. I can show you one of the methods. Actually, being a Rig Vedin, I follow the Rig Veda method of chanting Gayatri mantra. Om Bhur Bhuvasva Tatsa Vidurvare Nyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Na Prachodayata. So Pranava Om Bhur Bhuva Sva, and this Bhuva Sva is called Vyahridi. So Gayatri mantra starts from Tatsavidurvarenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Na Prachodayat. This is the mantra. So Gayatri needs to be chanted along with Pranava and Vyahridi. So during the Shivaratri, do Gayatri Japa, do Mahamrityunjaya Japa, and Panchakshari. How many times? Don't count. No need to count. He will count, or she will. Happy Shivaratri to all. Let the Lord Shiva, Vedamurti, bless us all with all his bounties. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.